Okay, hey, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be backtesting GU. We're going to be backtesting GU on the 5-minute charts using supply and demand. And the idea to this is we're going to backtest this for just 1 week, just to see exactly how much we can make, you know, what percentage of wins and losses that we can get. How I'm going to note this down is by using my notes, you know, just Apple notes. So how this is going to work is basically in March, when we get a win, we'll simply tally this wins. And if we get losses, we'll simply just tally losses, you know, just like normal tallies. And then we'll have the total win loss percentage at the end. The exit is pretty much 1-to-1. So what I'm looking for is 1-to-1s. I'm risking 1% to pretty much get 1%. Usually I only trade from 12 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. UK time. But because we're only backtesting for about 1 week, this means that I'm just going to trade London and New York, because sometimes I do, but these days I try not to, just so I can trade, you know, shorter on the day and spend the rest of my day doing other things. Now my strategy is also really simple. There's just a few things I'm looking for. Now I'm looking for a breaker structure to be pretty much present before I actually enter any trade. I'm only risking 1%, and I'm waiting for a break of candle before entering any trade. That's pretty much my entry. I'm looking for a break of candle, and then my TP is just a 101. I set a hard stop loss, and the trade becomes invalid if any candles does break the zone. And that is pretty much it. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. So currently on March 1st, and for London, I would only start trading from about 8:30. Let's say I wake up 8, do whatever I need to do, get on the charts from 8:30. So we're going to be trading from 8:30 a.m. every single day up till 3:30 p.m. You can see that price is currently bullish. I'm not looking for any trades just yet. We can see this nice bullish bar right here, but I'm not going to be entering that. And now we can see that price has actually broken a low, but we are looking for, so this has been a change of character, but we're looking for a breaker structure. So if price does break this next low once again, then we'll begin to actually look for some sort of setup. We can see that price failed to break the low again, and now it did. So in this case, we're looking for price to break this low. We're looking for price to get back here, sorry, and you know, then we'll see what actually happens afterwards. There is news at 3 p.m. So news pretty much caused price to dip, and we do have a supply. So we have a supply right here, which caused price to pretty much break this low. So now we can see that price is beginning to dip. If we also look at the EMA for more confirmation, EMA is going to be at the top as at, you know, 4. So we are looking for price to tap back in here, and we'll be looking for sells. So we see that price did exactly that, and we have a rejection candle. So stop loss is going to be right here. We're looking for 101. Pretty simple. So if price tags us in, so we can see that nice and easy, price pretty much tags us in straight in, and we're looking for it to pretty much give us our 1-to-1. So that was easy, nice and simple for the day. You know, it's literally just 4 p.m. So we entered this trade at 13:40. So the thing about this trade is this trade was pretty late in the day. Most of the time I wouldn't take it, just because I'm getting off the chart at 3:30. But if I see a setup like this and I'm waiting for it, because I've been waiting for this, I would have been waiting for this trade since 2:45. You know, something I'll just wait for, because it looks super clean, super, super, super clean. I could tell that this trade was gonna win from a mile away. So yeah, I mean, you know, nice 101 as well. This is the reason, exact reason to why I take 101s, because the moment it gave us that 1-to-1, it pretty much just, you know, went the other way. So in this case, we will take this, and this will be one win for the month of March. One thing we can see here is we actually see another supply. Price went back there and dumped again, but I'll be sleeping at this time because this is at 7:50, so I would have missed that trade. But now I'll be much awake, and now I'm looking for another trade right here. So this is the zone, because we can see, you know, price went back up, broke structure again, so we can see a nice break of structure. Let's just wait to see if price does tap back in. So price did go back in, but it broke above the zone, so I am not going to be entering this trade. This trade pretty much becomes invalid after that, just because it broke the zone. And afterwards, you can see that price is just pumping up. So in this case, now we can see a change of character. Now price has actually broken many highs. If it breaks another high, then we can say cool, maybe in that case price is wanting to go upwards. We can see another break of structure to the upside. You know, price did not break any more lows, now it's breaking another high. EMA is probably going, it's still at the top, So would I be looking for buyers yet? Not really. I'm not super confident in this trade at the moment. Yeah, price does break this low. This is why I don't really enter for aggressive entries. Aggressive entries is pretty much when you have it set that you should be entered into the trade immediately as soon as the price gets here, so you can get a very, very tight entry to try to make as much money as possible. But sometimes things like this happen where it just breaks through the zone and you just make literally absolutely no money. So in this case, price decided to dump. And now we have, you know, now price is going its normal course, just like it was before, you know, looking for sell. So it broke this low, it consolidated for a bit, broke this low again. And now we can see that price failed to go back up to this zone. So this zone right here is another supply. Supply is when, you know, there's aggressive selling and demand is when there's aggressive buying. So price failed to get here, but it also made another zone though right here. So another zone was formed because we can see another break of structure. So the break of structure that I'm talking about is right here. We can see that price just about broke structure, you know, it's a tiny mini tiny break of structure, but price did close above this, you know, lower low. Yeah, right here, pretty much price did actually, you know, just a tiny break of structure, but I still like how it looks. So I would be looking to enter right here. Break of candle. If price does break this candle, then my stop loss is going to be up here. Entry is going to be here, and we're looking for 101 down here. Price did not enter us in yet, so I'm going to move my entry up so I can get an even better entry. If I can enter just right here, you know, looking for another break of candle, stop loss is going to stay the same. But I'm still looking for my 101, so I'm just going to move my entry here. Now something like this I really like when I get better entries, because of course it means I can be out of the trade a lot easier. Second reason why I like this trade is because price does not have to break the low to give me my one-to-one. Usually when price has to break a low, there's a lot of, it needs more force, if you think about it that way, because it has to break a low, because that low acts as a point where price once rejected and failed to break. So in this case, price doesn't have to do that to give me my one-to-ones. So in this case, you can see another rejection and price has entered us in. So now, you know, yep, nice and quick. This is the reason I love supply and demand. Nice and quick. I don't like being in trades for too long. We got our one-to-one, you know, nice and simple. Even if I stayed a bit longer, I could make a tiny bit more money. And after that, we'll just see if price continued. I mean, price gave a bit more, but then, you know, just went straight the other way. And that is it. So that was literally at 2:30, and price went the other way after that. So it's currently 3:30, and we're pretty much done for the day, because after that price began to consolidate. So now that's two wins and so far that week. We're just going to continue for day three to see if we can see another trade. Now it's day three, it's Friday, so this would have been NFP week. So I am, to be fair, I'm guessing we might not find any trades at all, but I'm going to be very careful today, just because the chart's going to be absolutely messy. So far we can see that price is bullish. We're looking for buyers if possible. We haven't seen any highs being broken yet. Price has to break this high if we're going to even enter any trades at all. And so far, still not able to see any, because price has failed to close above that high. So now we've seen one. Okay, so now we can see a demand, aggressive buying that started from here. The perfect entry that I usually like is when, you know, entering from when price started from. So it started from here and then price, you know, pumped up, cooled off for a little bit, pumped up again. Some people would use this as a zone. I don't like it. I don't like using this, although yes, it kind of consolidated and broke. But I prefer this one just because this is where it started from initially. I prefer where it started from, and I'm just gonna wait until price gets there. Now in this case, so this isn't my entry I'm waiting for here, but let's just see what price does here for people who decided to enter from that zone. And we can see that some people would have been faked here, because they would have entered, you know, after this tiny break of structure right here, and then price would have just taken them out. So that's what I usually like to wait till, from where the initial supply or demand started from. So we're just waiting for price to go back to, you know, our entry, and we can see that it's tapped us in. So right now, the moment it's tapped me in, I'll be looking for buy right here. My stop loss will be down here, and I'm looking for my simple 101. In this case, for price to give my 101, it has to break this high. So I'm not the best, you know, this isn't like my 100% I'm confident in this trade sort of thing. But what I really like is when price goes down even more, because guess what? Now my entry can be down here, because now that's another break of candle that I'll be looking for. And my simple one-to-one is going to be really, really low right here. So this will be a nice quick trade if price decides to just pump up. Actually, no. Yeah, so I'm looking for my one-to-one, you know, right here. So if price actually breaks, so price has not actually gone up yet. So when this usually happens, it means clearly buyers do not have that momentum yet. So what I'll be looking for now, I have no entries yet. I'll be looking for price to first form a green candle, then I'll be looking for my entry. Especially when you have like a huge zone like this, price might want to come back down a bit more before going back up. So I'm just looking for any green candle first to form. So now this gives me that confidence that buyers might have the upper hand, or buyers are still coming in, because it's not really buyers in terms of us. We're not really moving the market too much, but now we can tell that buyers are simply entering the market now. So I'm still looking for my 101 now. From here, my stop loss will be just below this lowest low, and immediately, you know, all it took was 5 minutes. 5 minutes, boom, we got our money, we're out of this trade. In fact, I could have held. So this is a good thing. I could have held to make way more money. You know, I could have made a one to two, yeah, easy 1 to 2 on this trade if I really wanted to. Obviously trading live, yeah, this is a different story, but this was a nice easy 1 to 3, no red candles the entire time. But you know, following my rules anyway, I could have taken a 1-on-1, but if I wanted to take more, I would have taken more. So this was nice and simple trade. I really like that trade right there. But now that's another win in the month of March on NFP. So that's at 11:30 as well in the morning, so it's not even, you know, price hasn't gone crazy yet. We can see another break. So if price does come back here again, then I will be looking for another entry. And it's almost 3 o'clock though, so this is a very risky trade. Currently day 6 now. Okay, it's around 8:30 at this point, and now we are looking for what price is doing. Price has just been consolidating since, so we're looking for some sort of, okay, so price is broken. It's broken the low, but this is more of just a change of character. So I need price to break the low again before I start considering. Okay, so now we can see that price broke the low again. Consolidation, and now we see another break. Price hasn't really tapped in. The zone is literally up there. Price is kind of just dancing down there. So I'm just going to wait for price to tap into it properly, which it did here. So price tapped into it properly right here. My entry would be if it breaks this candle. Stop loss is right here. But then I'll take profit. It has to break the low. So it's not the best of the best. But now this is looking better. If price fails to break this zone, then that's good. So it means that I would simply be looking for a sell the moment we get a red candle. If we can get a red candle, then I'm looking for my entry. Okay, so now my entry would be down here. Stop loss is right up here. This is only 6 pips that we're risking, which is very, very good. Nice and low. Take profit is just going to be a nice 101. Okay, so we can see, let's see if what price does. Boom. Nice and clean. I like the momentum. And is price going to continue? Yeah, so nice and simple. You know, this took a bit longer. Sometimes it does take like 20 minutes, sometimes or a bit more. But easy. Another, you know, 101 that's there. And after that, price went straight, you know, the other way. This is what I really like my 1-to-1s for. Many, many, many people look for 1-to-2s, 1-to-3s, 1-to-20s, all of sorts. But from my experience, one thing I go with is experience over, not rules per se, but experience over just what people say. If I've experienced I'm winning more 1-to-1s, I'm going to take 1-to-1, because all I need to do is just stack up greens one day after another, and eventually the money is going to follow. Looking for 1-to-2s and stuff, it just doesn't work. Sometimes being too greedy doesn't work. I've experienced this multiple times. So these days, just set my 1-to-1, because you don't know what price is going to do. In this case, it literally gave a 1-to-1. And pretty much nothing more, really. And then it went the other way. So if I actually held, tried to take out liquidity and all sorts, I'd have probably lost this trade, because then I'll be longing for that same profit I saw earlier, and then I'll end up losing. I've done that multiple times. So in this case, that's another win. So that's 4 wins so far this week, and I believe there's one day left one more day to see exactly what prices. I forgot I wasn't done trading actually, so I haven't looked at what's happened. So let's just go back to here. This is why I just kind of fast forward, because sometimes I'll just make one trade a day and I'm done for the day. I won't even bother, because sometimes you then lose money and give money back. Like now, price is no longer going for sales. Technically, there's a zone right here. Do I like it though? It's not bad. I mean, let me just see. So breakout structure right here. I'll need to look at the EMA quickly. EMA is no longer at the top. It's kind of going through it. The thing about this is price could be correcting itself in the afternoon. So that's what usually sort of happens in the morning. Price does one thing. Afternoon price does the other. Overall trend is bullish. We can see that overall trend price has been upwards, though I took a sell here initially, but that's obviously because of this. I don't really pay too much attention to like the 1 hour and stuff. There's sometimes no need. If I can just kind of see what price is doing on the 5 minute, then I like that. But I already took money here, so I wouldn't really bother too much about this right now. I'm not super confident on here. I might be looking for buyers because price could just now be following the overall trend. So now I'll just leave this. Yeah, I'm not really too fussed about entering. And even if I did, yeah, I would have made money. If I did, I would have made money. But in this case, we just didn't enter, so we're just gonna leave it and carry on. If I can see another break or something, then maybe. Okay, so price does actually want to sort of go up. Oh, okay. So one thing I did miss. So we made money here earlier. Technically, what price then did was form a demand, right? Price formed the demand afterwards, right there, because then we can see that price broke this high. So if I was actually, if I paid, you know, attention there, then what I would have seen is, you know, 1 hour, everything is going smoothly, price is going upwards, price is following this trend, it broke this high, it broke another high. So yeah, this would have been clean. I would have entered from here, stop loss would have been all the way down here. Looking for a 101, so this would have been a win, but I missed it. So just to keep it fair and simple, so far in the month of March, how many wins have we got? So we got 1, 2, 3. Is that been it? 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Cool. So we've got 4 wins. Okay, that's correct. Yeah. Right. So yeah, I missed this one, and again, I missed this one, but. Yeah, so there would have been more wins, but I'm not going to record that down. So yeah, we're just going to wait until the next day. So now I'm just going to pay a bit more attention on the last day to make sure, you know, I don't miss any trades. And now we are here. So price again, I'm still looking for buyers because overall we can see price is breaking highs. So we're just going to wait and see if we can get any higher highs being formed and stuff. Okay, so price broke this low. I tried to go up, broke this low. If we can see another low being broken, then we can assume maybe price wants to start going lower. Okay, so we can see two lows being broken now. So now is when I'll be thinking, okay, let's try to find some sales. Although the overall trend is sort of buy on the higher time frame, not too worried about that. We can see another low being broken. And we can see the supply from here. So if price does go back up there, we'll consider. There's news at 3 p.m. So this is gonna mess us up. Yep, of course. If there was no news, I'm guessing price would have gotten there, but of course news had to mess this up. So we're just gonna see if, you know, anything else gonna happen. But then it's already 4 o'clock. So yeah, no trades pretty much on the last day. Yeah, no trades this day. I mean, I considered this one here, because price did a quick, you know, broke the low, re-entered, retested, and then start dumping. But it's already 4 p.m. so I don't like it. So overall, in the week, we got 4 wins. So in this case, that's just 100% in that week. We could have made more, of course, because we missed those initial two. This one as well was 4 p.m. so I guess no, this doesn't really count, but those two could have been an easy win. So that's been it. If you guys do enjoy videos like this, be sure to let me know down in the comments below, and I do thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.